As we've heard over and over, this bill tries to fix something that isn't broken. We've heard over and over again that it's a solution in search of a problem, and we keep hearing it because it's the truth. Impersonation at the polling place, voter impersonation, is the only fraud that this bill attempts or tries to address, which is virtually non-existent in Pennsylvania. But in order to get at a so-called problem that really does not exist, this bill will endanger the constitutional right to vote of thousands of Pennsylvanians. And that's the real agenda for this bill. It's an attack on people of usually limited means, who tend not to vote the way that the Republicans would like them to vote. And after last year's budget and the budget proposal this year, where you cut basic education, cut higher education, matter of fact, parents and children will find it harder and harder, almost impossible, to afford a college education in our state universities because of these budget proposals. You've cut programs for the disabled seniors, disabled children. You've cut programs for seniors. After all the cuts we've just listed, it's no wonder that you want to keep people from coming to the polls. You don't want people to vote. And it's interesting, we found out just here, right now we got a memo or an email from the governor's office saying we found new money somewhere that we can fund a program that was virtually cut out to get people who need Medicaid, seniors on Medicaid, and to their doctors, and to get seniors out to other services. But we found money to put them back in place so we can get them to our PennDOT centers so they can get their free voter ID card. Well, I want to talk about that so-called free voter ID card. First of all, it's not free. And let's look at what's involved and what is required to get a PennDOT-issued non-driver's ID card. In order to get a PennDOT non-driver's ID card, you have to complete an application and provide proof of identification. What type of identification does PennDOT require? PennDOT requires that you provide a non-laminated Social Security card. And two, one of the following documents: a valid passport, a birth certificate, an Immigration and Naturalization Service document proving citizenship or naturalization. Photocopies are not accepted, and the documents must be original documents. And in addition to those requirements, you also must provide two of the following: a lease agreement, mortgage documents, a current weapons permit, current utility bills, or a W-2 form or tax records. Now, to review those basic requirements, in order to receive a non-driver's license ID, citizens must provide a non-laminated Social Security card. Many people don't have a Social Security card at all. We did a little survey just on my staff, and we've got three who do not possess a non-laminated Social Security card. So what's involved in obtaining a non-laminated Social Security card? The good news is the Social Security card is free. The bad news is twofold. First, in order to get a replacement Social Security card, you must provide original versions. Copies are not accepted of one of the following: a valid passport, a U.S. driver's license, a U.S. birth certificate, or a state-issued ID. Of these choices, a person seeking replacement Social Security card, in order to get a PennDOT-issued non-driver's license, has no choice but to obtain a valid U.S. passport or certified copy of their birth certificate. And it should be noted that the only valid birth certificate for these IDs is the United States birth certificate. So, if you were born overseas, if you were born to military parents overseas, you must obtain a passport. Passports are not free. Passports take months to obtain and cost $140. You can expedite that and pay another $60, so it'll cost you $200. There is nothing free about a $140 or $200. For United States citizens born here in the United States, the birth certificate seems to be the way to go. Certified copies of U.S. birth certificates, if you can't obtain one, are not free either. They must be obtained from the Department of Health, and they cost $10 apiece. If you pay for that copy of your birth certificate by money order through the mail, the price goes up to $13. And if you pay online with a credit card, you will be charged $20. Mr. Speaker, whether it's 20, 13, or 10, or even just $1, it is not free. And remember, this would be required for United States citizens to exercise their right to vote, a constitutional right at the heart of what our country was founded on. It takes approximately 3 to 4 months to get a copy of a birth certificate. Thanks to the deep budget cuts that Governor Corbett and our Republican colleagues made last year. Now, it looks like the governor may be saying he found money, so we will continue to cut higher education, basic education, so we could pass this bill that makes no sense. He will find money so that he may shorten the 3 to 4 month period so you can get a photo ID to vote, a citizen to get a photo ID to vote. We'll see. If you were born in another state, what do you do? I have no idea what you do, and I guarantee you that it will cost you a lot of money and take months to obtain the documents you need to receive. It won't be easy. It won't be free. Now, once a person seeking a so-called free PennDOT-issued non-driver's license pays either up to $20 for a birth certificate or $140 for a passport, then wait several weeks or months for them to arrive, that person will receive a non-laminated replacement Social Security card. And remember, that's just the first step in being able to vote. So that same person will be required to return to PennDOT with the non-laminated replacement Social Security card and either the newly obtained $140 U.S. passport or the newly obtained $20 birth certificate. And still, that American citizen will not be able to vote under the mandates of this bill. That's because PennDOT requires more documentation to get the so-called free non-driver's license ID. That American citizen, after already shelling out anywhere from $10 to $150 for required documents, will still be required to provide a lease agreement, a mortgage document, a valid weapons permit, current utility bills, or a W-2 form, or some other tax record. If you are lucky enough to own your own home with no mortgage, if you don't carry a gun, are retired, and have a spouse who pays the utilities, you are not fortunate enough to be able to obtain a PennDOT-issued ID unless your utility-paying spouse accommodates you to PennDOT to vouch for your residence and you bring along magazines or other mail containing your name and address. But what if you're a woman who married and took your husband's name? If you spend that $10 or $20 to get a copy of your birth certificate, you still can't vote. You can't vote because your name on your birth certificate won't match your mail. So PennDOT requires that you also provide a certified copy of your marriage license. Guess what? A certified copy of your marriage license is not free. It can only be obtained from the county where you were married. And in Pennsylvania, the cost and wait times for obtaining a marriage license depends on what county you're from. And it varies county by county. If you were married in another state or another county, I can't imagine the hurdles you are going to have to overcome and the price you'd have to pay for your right to vote. Only after that American citizen obtains a certified copy of your marriage license, that is only when you can obtain your so-called free PennDOT-issued ID card. And by that point, that American citizen will have paid upwards of $200 just to exercise their right to vote. Mr. Speaker, all of us should be honest about what this requirement is, because it's not free. It is not free. This is a stealth poll tax. We are going back to the old days. It is a stealth poll tax. It is wrong. It is undemocratic. It is un-American. This bill should not be concurred in. It should be thrown out. It should be voted against. We need to protect people's right to vote. We need to encourage people to go to the polls, not discourage them, not deprive them of their right to vote for reasons that are suspect. And we all know they are. The goal of this bill is to suppress voter turnout in Pennsylvania in a presidential year. And it costs hundreds of dollars for your senior citizens, for your disabled, for folks that are down on their luck to be able to go out and exercise their right to vote. That's what this bill is about, and that's why it should be defeated. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.